or anything, right?
Oh, me?
Okay, all right. What did Drew do to get his pop all puffed up with pride? What's up?
Last night, he gave us his blessing, you know, on this, little plan that, that Nora and I have.
Blessings?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Are you talking about what I think you're talking?
Having a baby.
Oh, man, you are in for a ride.
Nora's already got me practicing all my diapering skills, all that stuff. But I started thinking about this. And you know what? I'm going to get a chance to experience all the stuff that I missed out on before.
So, my friend, see, what you've got is that old baby fever. No, really, you know, you grow a few inches taller, or at least you think you do. Yeah. And then you start to become really handy around the house. And you see all those ladies on the street, and you start to tell them how cute their kids are. And then you imagine miles and miles of electric trains. But the worst, the absolute worst, is you get this dumb, stupid smile on your face that you just can't wipe off. Yeah, just like that one right there. That's the smile I'm talking about.
That's about it.
All right, have you actually ever changed a diaper?
Nope.
Don't you worry, buddy. I'll walk you through it. But listen, a word of caution. When Nora was pregnant, she drove me crazy. She had to have everything right here, right now, all the time. Made me nuts.
Well, I'll tell you something. The way I feel about Nora right now, whatever she wants, whatever, I'll go all the way to the end of the earth to bring it to her.
Look, Mrs. Carpenter. Hey, I'll call 911.
I don't know what happened. I was just standing here, and then this cop barrels into me. Somebody else get out, and then there was a gunshot. It's just
losing a lot of blood. You really got to help me, really.
The cop.
Was it her?
I don't know. Cassie, sweetheart, you got to help me!
Drew, honey, it's going to be okay. Joey's called 911.
Hurry up, please. You're gonna be fine. You're gonna be fine. I'm sorry.
Secure the crime scene and get forensics in here. But first, give Mr. Buchanan some time alone with his son.
Not gonna leave you. It's not time to make a change. Just relax, take it easy. You're still young, that's your fault. There's so much you have to know. Find a girl, settle down. If you want, you can marry. Look at me, I am old, but I'm happy. I was once like you are now, and I know that it's not easy to be calm when you found something going on. But take your time, think a lot. Why, think of everything you've got, for you will still be here tomorrow, but your dreams may not.
Stay tuned for scenes from the next One Life to Live.
Time to make a change. Just sit down, take it slowly. You're still young, that's your fault. There's so much you have to go through. Find a girl, settle down. If you want, you can marry. Look at me, I am old, but I'm happy.
Mr. Buchanan was trying to communicate something. Maybe he recognized his killer. He was a good cop. On the job, right to the end.
I'm going to make some calls and see if I can track down Bo. Excuse me.
Excuse me, Renee. Tonight. He was like a little kid, you know? Just so excited about his fishing trip. He had planned with his dad for tomorrow. Carrying around a fishing lure that they found right over there when he died.
Day tomorrow. Just enough breeze blowing to ruffle a water full of fish. Be done in about 5 hours. That's when the big ones really bite. And the rest of the day, just kick back. Just relax. Stare where the line disappears into the water and wait for a nibble. You can talk. We're really gonna get to know each other. You ever play Little League? I was a shortstop. You would have been a great first baseman. That stretch. Call it.